asking somebody what it's like to have an epileptic seizure is a pretty broad question because I would be saying, which type and for how long would I have that seizure and what would my mood be like that day? But I think that's quite a good kind of an explanation of how much they vary, and it does depend on the person and, of course, on the drugs and stuff that you take too. If I'm to describe what I would feel like after a tonic-clonic, I'll give you one example. And first of all, I had it in the bathroom, so I slipped and luckily didn't crack my head open. But I did wake up with my head in a bucket, which I was kindly told afterwards. I couldn't remember even who my boyfriend was for an hour after my seizure. I was very, very confused, but I was very aware that I was confused, and that made me really upset, and I was crying, and I was embarrassed. I'm obviously not embarrassed right now, but at the time, not knowing what I've done, what might have happened, you just don't know what somebody might have seen, especially if you've defecated, or which we know is so common, and nobody intends for that to happen. But at the time, it's really embarrassing. And another example, actually, I had a seizure which developed from a less severe kind through to the one where I was shaking on the floor. And I'd started stripping in my workplace in front of about 250, 300 people. And you can imagine, I'm not fully conscious when I come out. I had the most awful headache. It's like, imagine the worst migraine in the world. I partially stopped breathing. So, yeah, I had a bit of a headache. Yeah. And then seeing that I'd pulled my skirt up, luckily I'd been very open so about my epilepsy. So, my colleagues were great and they covered me up and stuff. But all these people around me, it's pretty embarrassing. And then I just wanted to get up. Oh my gosh, I'm going to be okay. And people are like, no, dude, it's all right. But I struggled to move anyway. I couldn't even get up. And then that frustration, oh my God, I was so frustrated that I couldn't move because I know. And then you get to that stage where you can think clearly, but you can't move. Or you can think clearly, or at the same time, but you can't articulate what you're thinking. And so I once had a paramedic say to me, are you diabetic? Can I come on, you're diabetic? Because my blood sugar had fallen. They did the pr I wasn't diabetic, but it's pretty common for your blood sugar to fall if you've had a tonic-clonic seizure. But they didn't know that. And then he had me worrying that, have I developed diabetes? And I thought, oh my God, am I going to have another seizure now? Because I was getting so stressed out. So it's just really important to be aware of just how people can often understand what you're saying, even if they can't say anything back, to know that they might be feeling embarrassed or ashamed, even though they shouldn't, but at the time you do. And to know that if they're getting a bit angry, they can be angry at themselves as well. And sometimes people can get aggressive, but that's not the real person. Just know, I mean, it's not common, but sometimes that can happen, but it's not them, it's just their brain being more than a little annoying temporarily. And it's exhausting and it can take days to recover. It's not like that for everybody. For some people, they recover so much more quickly. And if I have a less severe seizure, same here, totally. But you've just got to be open to how the person feels and how that particular seizure or cluster of seizures may have affected them. And you can have a person that has. One person here who has a focal seizure, another person here who has a focal seizure, one will be exhausted for a week and one person won't. And you don't know why, but that's okay. Put it on the notes and tell the neurologist, and who knows, who knows what the reason is, but yeah, that's what the docs are there for.